What is it between you and Kevin? Is it a personal problem? I say no. You see, it's a physical problem. I get physically ill when I think of the thought of living the rest of my professional career in the same organization as Kevin Sullivan. So I'm telling you right here and right now, Kevin, if I can't beat you, I'm taking a walk because I'd rather join the circus and clean up after the elephants. Bang, bang! Bang, bang!
You know, my brother, I've heard a lot of wrestlers come out here and they holler and they tell what they're gonna do. They say they're gonna hurt people and they never do. You know what the problem was?
When
Cactus did that, he did it to me. And Cactus Jack, when you lay your weary head down at night and hear the wind call my name, the storm is gonna get you September 18th.
All right, Cactus Jack, Kevin Sullivan, former tag team partners collide head on. The loser on this one will be banished from World Championship Wrestling. New U.S. champ Ricky Steamboat defends against a fuming challenger in stunning Steve Austin. In other title action, WCW Tag Team Champions Pretty Wonderful defend against Stars and Stripes. And World Television Champion Lord Steven Regal locks up with the exciting Johnny B. Badd. If you can't join us in Roanoke, join us live on pay-per-view cable TV. 2 weeks from tomorrow night, Sunday, September the 18th, at 7 o'clock Eastern Time, satellite dish owners call Turner Premier. Make plans now to be part of the excitement of Ball Brawl, the War Games.
All right, Ball Brawl, and now we know one other match brain. It's going to be Loser Leave WCW, Kevin Sullivan. And...
all right, fans, joining me at this time, brothers Kevin and Dave Sullivan.
Evad Sullivan.
Evad, if you prefer. I see you've got an envelope there, Dave. What's in there?
Yes, I was really concerned about the Hulkster for what happened at the class, so I went out and got him a get well card and hoping he's feeling better. And I would really appreciate it, Mr. Oakland, if you'd give this to him since you're
well, I'm going to be out in Los Angeles.
Wait a minute! Don't worry about the Hulkster. Worry about getting a tombstone, either for myself or Cactus Jack. You understand? Someone's going to pay. Either me or him ain't going to be around anymore. You know what happens with people that have tombstones over the what?
I'm not here no more. I want you to be here.
Let me tell you what. Cactus Jack, I'm going to make something real clear. This is my brother. And I can do that to him. But when you did it, you crossed the line. Cactus, you're the man that crossed the so tough. You're the man that laid in the desert. You're the man that has sent everybody packing. This week or next week, it doesn't matter. Cactus, I'm a fair man, and I'm going to beat you fairly, squarely, and all over the ring. I demand retribution. I demand the Sullivan's name to be cleared. You, Cactus Jack, have no guts if you don't show up Saturday night and face me. We don't have to wait for the Fall Brawl, Cactus. That will be just icing on the cake. Go get a tombstone. Chisel his name.
What? Don't hurt him.
I'm out, and I'm going to hurt you if you don't smarten up.
Kevin, you've got to lighten up. This is your brother, my word.
He's going to lighten up. You see, this has gone too far. He isn't your friend. I'm your brother.
Gentlemen, I thank you very much. This man doesn't want to wait till Fall Brawl. He wants Cactus Jack as soon as he can get him. More Saturday night in a minute. Don't go away.
Be sure to join us tonight at 10 o'clock. The replay of one of the biggest clash of the champions ever. Hogan versus Flair tonight.
Hulk, my hotline has been ringing off the hook. I know yours has too. People around the country, all over the world, have been expressing tremendous concern at what happened to you at the Clash of Champions. I know you've been seeing orthopedic people regarding that knee, but can you give us a real quick update? What's the status of it?
Well, Gina, we're kind of boxed in at this point in time. You know, I've been hanging with Dr. Doug over there in Tampa, brother, and Bob Ponovich, man, is my main man. They're putting it back together, but what we're dealing with now is... it may have been better if it was broken. What we're dealing with right now, Gino, is a lot of stuff that's floating around. We get some tendons that are torqued the wrong way. And basically, it's going to be time, man. We're kind of boxed in right now, but I'm just glad that I've got the clash behind me. But we're real not happy about the way things went down. And, you know, when you talk about hotlines, the hotlines here, man, yeah, my phone's ringing off the hook, the Hulk Hogan hotline, but these kids are upset, man, because when I went to the WCW, I promised them one thing. I was going to make this Hulkamania run forever. You know, Brutus is out here, Brother Brutus covering my back, man, you know. But it's so different now because, you know, I thought when I went to the WCW, I thought things were going to be different. You know, you got Bockwinkel as a president. You got Bill Shaw running around tooting his horn. You got Bischoff, you know, playing the game. And nobody seems to have a handle on Ric Flair. I mean, when you talk about aggravation, you know, you might as well go ahead and put Flair's name at the top of the list. Everything he's doing has been a setup, and they've got me boxed in. Big deal.
I mean, it's a conspiracy. You take a look at Flair, Sensuous Sherry, even Bobby Heenan, who's made some ridiculous accusations.
Oh, man, they're all working together. I mean, it's as plain as the sun is shining. If you'd have to be a fool not to realize that Heenan, with Flair, they're all trying to set me up, you know, but the bottom line is this. There's nothing they can do about it, brother. I'm the champion of the WCW. The 30-day return clause is okay.
What? You're the one that brought that up. You may have boxed yourself in, I guess.
Yeah, and there's no way Ric Flair could pin me. You saw what happened at the Clash. Every cheap shot in the book, he still couldn't get the job done.
I'm very curious. Are you going to be able to defend the WCW heavyweight crown? The condition of that knee, the psychological condition right now, do you want to? Do you mentally feel up to it?
Well, it's all attitude, brother. And the way I feel right now, Ric Flair, he won the battle, but he's not going to win the war. You know, when you talk about me jumping back in the ring, we're a week away from the injury. I mean, it was a week ago this went down, brother. You know, and I got a little bit of downtime. Even if every 30 days Bockwinkel made me fight Godzilla or King Kong, I'd be there. I'd be up for it because I've got these kids, man. I got these maniacs that I'm fighting for. But, you know, the bottom line is this. Whether it's Vader, whether it's one of Flair's other buddies running around the WCW, I'll climb in the ring no matter what it is. But the bottom line is, why don't we box Ric Flair in? Why don't we put Bischoff? Why don't we put the so-called boxing for the president of the WCW, all these clowns? Why don't we put Bill Shaw in there? I mean, why don't we just shoot this thing straight? Why don't they make it a fair playground for all these athletes that we can get in the ring and find out who is the best wrestler?
You know, I would vote for that in a heartbeat, and I'd like to see it happen, Hulk. I really would, but I don't know. Today, it's just so confusing.
Well, let me tell you something, man. Ric Flair and everything he's got going, the way Ric Flair is tooting his own horn, we might say, you know, if we could play. No, I got one more thing to say, Brutai.
It ain't even worth it.
No, I got one more thing to say. You make sure all your ducks are in a row, because I know they are now, but you find Ric Flair for me. Why don't you throw this microphone up in front of his face when he's not ready like you do to me all the time?
Come on, Hulk, give me a break. I didn't mean to impose.
No, I know whose side you're on, brother. But when you come out here asking about the knee, that's one thing. But then you lead me into all these other questions. What are you going to do if Bockwinkel throws you in the ring again in 30 days? What are you going to do if the tables turn?
Calm down, Hulk. Why don't you just ask? I'll ask him. If I get the chance.
You tell him, brother, knee or not, I'm ready for him.
All right,
Jimmy Hart, and of course, WCW heavyweight champion Hulk Hogan. I've not seen him in that frame of mind for a long, long time. Not good, but I know the champion. I know he's going to be back. Wow.
All right, so that's from me, Gene Okerlund. And your name was brought up too there, Brain.
Oh, what is this, spring break? Oh, the kiddies are going to throw the frisbee, throw the ball. That man's not hurt. Hogan isn't hurt one bit. He's gone. Go for it, man. It's cool.
Yeah, sure it is. Our thanks to me, Gene Okerlund, for that.
Yeah. Forrest Gump in a sports coat at the beach.
And I don't know, maybe we can locate Ric Flair to see what he has to say. Even though he's been...
Why? Who cares? No one cares about Flair. He's suspended definitely. Who cares? What would you care for?
All right, the Guardian Angel in this one-on-one matchup. Heenan, Vader, and Sting.
Oh!
He's going to end it all right here. 2, 3, and Vader's come out with a chair.
I'm getting out of here, Shivani.
Vader has come out with a chair here on Saturday night.
Let me get behind you here.
They want to get it on right now, two enemies, and here comes Sting.
Now, wait a minute. Oh, there are no favorites here.
That's right, all three men in the triangle match.
It's every man for themselves.
That's right, and Bob Brawl, Doug Dellinger, head of security, has come out. What do we got? We got a standoff here. Vader and Angel, Vader and Sting and Angel. Just about out of time. Here on Saturday night, what a wild event this triangle match is going to be.
I've never seen anything like it. You should put Dillinger in there. He deserves it.
Sting and Vader. Arch enemies know each other quite well.
And Vader and the Guardian don't.
Yeah, right now, though, Sting and the Guardian Angel going to Mean Gene Okerlund.
All right, things a bit chaotic here at World Championship Wrestling. Guardian A, hold on a second now, gentlemen. We know that you two are going to be involved in two-thirds of the triangle match, and the third man is going to be none other than Vader, but let's try control that till September the 18th.
I know you're a man that believes in law, order, and justice, and fair play, just like I do. I believe that's the reason you came out here and watched my back. Stinger, I want to let you know right now, I appreciate that, man. I really do. But come September the 18th in Roanoke, bottom line is, they're going to flip a coin. They're going to try to figure out who the number one contender is for that world championship belt. And I pray to God that it's Vader, because every chance I get, I put hands on him. It's one chance to run him out of WCW back in that hole him and Harley Race crawled out of and never to be seen again. But when they flip that coin, and it's me and you, I want you to remember we're friends and we're pals. The bottom line is, when I look across that ring and stare you in the eyes, we're going to be strangers, boy.
Well, that's the reality of a triangle match, and you know the stakes, Sting.
All I got to say is go for it, because I know I will.
All right, tensions are running very, very high as these men prepare for ball the board game.